वेलकम अगेन इन दिस कोर्स फील्ड्स गैलवास थ्योरी। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी दैट एक्सटेंशन डिग्रीज आर मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इन द सेंस दैट सपोज आई हैव एफ इज ए सब फील्ड ऑफ के एंड K is a subfield of L, which actually implies that F is also a subfield of L. Then there are three associated extension degrees. The degree of extension of K over L, the degree of extension of L over K, and the degree of extension of L over F. So what is the relationship among these degrees? We would see in the form of the next theorem. So the theorem is, so let F subfield of K and K is a subfield of L. So these are extensions. L is an extension of K, K is an extension of F. Be extensions, be field extensions. Then degree of extension of L over F is the multiplication of the degree of extension of L over K, K over F. So in that sense we can say that the extension degrees are multiplicative. That is, extension degrees are multiplicative. Where if one side of the equation is infinite, the other is also infinite. Where if one side of the equation is infinite, the other is also infinite. Is also infinite. So this is the theorem, and this theorem has a lot of applications, as you would see in the future lectures. Now if you want to see it pictorially, so you have here F is contained in K is contained in L. So here you have degree of extension of L over K, here you have degree of extension of K over F, and on the top of these two you have degree of extension of L over F. So of course the degree of extension of L over F is bigger than these two degrees, because L is a larger field. So K as a vector space over F is a subspace of L as a vector space over F, and also L also forms a vector space over K. Now see the proof of this theorem. Now suppose first, suppose that both are finite. I would assume that L over K is also finite extension. So say it is M, so degree is M, and the degree of K over F is say N. Now choose a basis of K over L and a basis of F over K. So let alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha m be a basis for L over K, and basis for L over K, and say beta 1, beta 2, so on, beta n be basis of for K over F, be a basis for K over F. Now we choose an element, any arbitrary element L in L. So L would be a linear combination of these m basis vectors. So L you can write as a1 alpha 1 plus a2 alpha 2 plus so on plus am alpha m, where these ais, the scalars, they are in K, where a1, a2, so on, am, they belong to K. Now once they are in K, and K is a vector space over F, so these beta i's, they are basis of K over F. So therefore this means that each ai is a linear combination of these beta i's, beta j's. Now each ai is an F linear combination, means the scalar would come from F. F linear combination, F linear combination of, F linear combination of these beta 1, beta 2, so on, beta n. So this means we have ai equals say bi1 beta 1 plus bi2 beta 2 plus so on plus up to bin beta n for I running from 1 to n, for I equals 1, 2, so on up to n, and where these bij's, they are in F, and the coefficients, the scalars bij, they belong to F. Now say this equation is star. Now substituting the values of each ai from here into this equation star would give us the value of L as, so this means L would become, L is now of the form B11 beta 1 plus so on plus B1n beta n of alpha 1, so this is the value of A1, plus B21 beta 1 plus so on plus B2n beta n alpha 2 plus 1, and at last we will have bm1 beta 1 plus so on plus bmn beta n alpha m. And if we club these values in terms of these beta i's, okay, so this would be equal to b11 alpha 1 plus so on plus bm1 alpha m beta 1 plus b12 alpha 1 plus so on plus bm2 alpha m of beta 2 plus so on plus at last I will have b1n alpha 1 plus so on plus bmn alpha m of beta n. And if I write this in the form of a summation, it would imply that L is nothing but summation I running from 1 so on m, j running from 1 so on n, bij alpha I beta j. Now where these mn elements, they are in L, where the mn elements alpha I beta j, they are in L, and these bij's mn scalars, they are in F, and bij they are in F. So this means what? This means these mn elements alpha I beta j, they span L as a vector space over F. So this means alpha I beta j span L as a vector space over F. Okay, now we will show that they are also, these mn elements, they are also linearly independent. For this, suppose such a linear combination is 0. Now if this linear combination I running from 1 to m, j running from 1 to n, bij alpha I beta j, if this is 0, this means from this equation we would get that this equation is 0. Okay, so this would actually imply that b11 beta 1 plus so on plus b1n beta n alpha 1 plus so on plus bm1 beta 1 plus so on plus bmn beta n of alpha m equals 0. But what are these? This is nothing but a1, so on. This is nothing but am. So this implies that a1 alpha 1 plus a 2 alpha 2 plus 1 plus a m alpha m, m is 0. But these alpha I, they are bases for L over K. So this means each AI must be 0. Because being bases, they must be linearly independent. Now as alpha 1, so on alpha m are bases for L over K, for L over K, because these scalars AI, they are from K. So it follows that, it implies that AI equal to 0 for all I running from 1 to N. Okay, once AI 0, this means from this equation, B11 beta 1 plus 1 plus B1N beta N is 0. Likewise, B21 beta 1 plus 1 plus B2N beta N is 0 and so on. BM1 beta 1 plus 1 plus BMN beta N equals 0. But again, using the fact that these beta j's, j running from 1 to n, they are bases, they are bases of k over f, they are bases for k over f, and these scalars bij's, they are from f. So this means in each of these equations every bij is 0. So this means bij is 0 for all I comma j, 1 less than or equal to I, less than or equal to m, 1 less than or equal to j, less than or equal to n. So this means if such a linear combination is 0, so all the scalars are 0, so it means that alpha I beta j are linearly independent over f. So they form a basis for L over f. So form a basis for L over f. Okay. So how many elements they are? They are mn elements. So therefore, the dimension, so the degree of L over f is mn. But m is nothing but degree of L over k, and n is nothing but degree of k over f. So degree of extension of L over f is the multiplication of the degree of extension of L over k and k over f. So as claimed, so the extension degrees are multiplicative. Now the second part, what happens if one of the equations is infinite? Now suppose on the right side one of equation is infinite, so then right side would become, so on right side, if one of the dimensions is infinite, the right side would become infinite. So we would have to ensure that in that case, the left side would also have to be infinite. And if left hand side is infinite, the right hand side must also be infinite. So first I assume that k over f is infinite. So if k over f is infinite, so the degree of extension of k over f is infinite, but k over f is a subspace of L over f, but k is a subspace subspace of L over F. So this means L over F in that case must also be infinite. So this means L over F is also infinite, must also be infinite, must be infinite. Now, what happens if this is infinite? Also, if L over K is infinite, suppose L over K is infinite, then means what? There are infinitely many elements of L linearly independent over K. It means infinitely many elements of L are linearly independent over K. But then those elements must also be linearly independent over F, because F is a subfield of K. So must also be linearly independent over F. They can't be linearly dependent over F, because F is a subfield of K. So again, in this case also we have that L over F is infinite. So if one of these degrees is infinite, the degree on the left hand side is infinite. Now if, and the other case follows from the case one that we have just seen. Now if L over F is infinite, then these two must be infinite. No, at least one of these two must be infinite. Because if both of these are finite, then we have just seen that this is finite. Okay. Also, so finally, L over F infinite implies at least L over K or K over F infinite. Because if both of these are finite, then this is finite. So we are two. Okay. So if one side of the equation is infinite, the other is also infinite. So infinite case is actually not that important. The finite case, the finite part of this theorem is very applicable for us, for our future course of study. And as a finite case of this theorem, we have a corollary, which says that, so corollary of this theorem is, suppose L is a finite extension of F, is a finite extension. And K be any subfield of F containing L. So K is the intermediate field. And K be any subfield of L containing F. So that is, so we have actually this type of situation F is contained in K, is K is contained in L. Then this degree of extension of K over F divides degree of extension of L over F. And this is straightforward from this one. Okay. So degree of because this degree is mn and this degree is n. So n clearly divides mn. So we would use this corollary in our examples later on. So this is a very important theorem. It actually shows that the extension degrees are multiplicative. Now, this theorem also shows that finite extension of a finite extension is finite. Okay. So as a remark or as a corollary, you can again write finite extension of a finite extension is finite. So finite over finite is finite, because if L over K is finite and K over F is finite, then L over F is also finite. We have seen that if L over K is M, K over F is N, then L over F is MN. This is just we have seen. So finite over finite is finite. Now let us see a few examples. So this theorem would help us to conclude so many things about finite extensions. So it actually makes our job very easy, as you would see in these examples. Suppose I take K equals to the field Q alpha, where alpha is the real root of this polynomial x cube minus 3x minus 1. Okay. This polynomial is irreducible over Q, because this is a cubic polynomial and has no rational root. So therefore it is irreducible over Q. So therefore, being monic irreducible, it is actually the minimal polynomial of alpha. So therefore the degree of extension of Q alpha over Q must be 3. Now, I can single-handedly say that square root of 2 does not belong to Q alpha. This theorem would help me to actually see this. Otherwise, it is not easy to claim this if we don't have this theorem. How? Because if square root of 2 belongs to this field Q alpha, then the field generated by square root 2, that is Q root 2, should be contained in this field Q alpha. And degree of extension, now see here. So we have actually Q contained in Q root 2, contained in Q root alpha. So degree of extension of Q alpha over, sorry, the degree of extension of Q alpha over Q, okay, yes, is degree of extension of Q alpha over Q root 2 multiplied by degree of extension of Q root 2 over Q. This is what this theorem says. Or in other words, you can say that degree of extension of Q root 2 divides this degree. But degree of extension of Q root 2 is 2, this is 3, and 2 cannot divide 3. So this means our claim that square root of 2 does not belong to Q alpha is true. Okay, so very helping theorem. in that sense. So now this theorem is also helpful in finding the degree of extensions of so many finite fields. Sorry, degree of extensions of so many finite extensions, especially the extensions generated by some elements. Simple extensions are generated by finite number of elements. For example, so second example, if I take alpha is equal to sixth root of 2, okay, and take this extension q alpha of q, okay, where this is the positive real, this is the real sixth root of 2, sixth root of 2. Now, if I take sixth root of 2 cube, it is actually square root 2. So this means what? So this means actually that square root 2 belongs to the field q alpha, or you can say q sixth root 2. So therefore, this extension q root 2 must be contained in the extension q sixth root of 2. So now you have this situation, q contained in q root 2 contained in q sixth root of 2. Okay, now I can simply find the degree of extension of q root 2, no, degree of extension of this q of sixth root 2 over q root 2 by using this theorem. How? Because I know that the degree of extension of q of sixth root 2 over q is degree of extension of q of sixth root 2 over q root 2 and then multiplied by the degree of q root 2 over q. Now this degree is 6 because the minimal polynomial for alpha over q is x raised to power 6 minus 2. Okay, so this degree is 6 and this degree I know, this degree is 2. So the only choice for this is that it must be 3. Okay, so this means degree of extension of q of 6th root 2 over q must be 3. And it also actually shows that the minimal polynomial, sorry, q root 2, degree of extension of this over q root 2 is 3. Okay, in particular it also shows that the minimal polynomial for 6th root 2 over q root 2 is of degree 3. Okay, so it also shows that the minimal polynomial of alpha equal to 6th root 2 over q root 2 is of degree 3. So such a nice theorem it is, as it helps us in so many ways. So we will see you in the next lecture.